This is Shannie from Baker Creek, and today I want to give you my favorite heat-tolerant greens. Maybe by the middle of the summer, even spring for some of you in the super southern regions, you're losing your greens, your leafy greens like spinach and lettuce, to bolting. Things are starting to go to seed. Heat can really stress out some of those more cool weather loving greens, but you still want to have those amazing salads all summer. So I'm going to give you my favorite choices for heat tolerant greens. These are things that love the heat, thrive in the heat. They look beautiful in the garden throughout the summer. So you're going to get densely nutritious plants and they're going to look great. My number one choice for edible ornamentals that provide leafy greens throughout the hot season would be Malabar spinach. The Latin name is Baselia rubra. So this is a red stemmed variety of Malabar spinach. It's got kind of a almost an okra-like texture. It's got a light bit of mucilage to it, which I really like, and it actually is great for digestion when plants have that quality. It's a really densely nutritious green. It's rich in vitamins A and vitamin C. It makes this really nice vine. I love the habit of this plant. It's going to twine and vine up whatever you train it up, so you can make a nice trellis and it's going to grow beautifully. It makes these nice little berries that turn deep purple in the fall. So it's a really, it's a handsome plant. It's a great edible ornamental, and this is going to provide leafy greens throughout the whole season. These are excellent cooked. You can eat them raw. They don't have any bitter flavor to them. They're not sour. They're very mild. One of the more closer flavors to spinach that I've found. So it's a great spinach substitute. Use it just like you would use spinach. And it makes an amazing edible ornamental, so you have to try Malabar spinach. Komatsuna is one of the most heat-tolerant Asian greens. Asian greens have that signature light mustardy, spicy flavor balanced with sweet. They're really a nuanced, incredible, refreshing flavor, and they're always really juicy and crisp. And a lot of times you're enjoying that those Asian greens during the cooler weather. But Komatsuna loves the heat. It's going to grow well in the heat of the summer, and it's going to give you that signature mustardy Asian green flavor in the heat of the summer. So perfect for stir fries. Pair this in a stir fry with things like long beans and garlic and bitter melon. It's absolutely beautiful. Adds that spicy, pungent note, but it's also nice and balanced and kind of sweet. It's a highly gourmet green that you can produce even in the heat of summer. One of the most heat-tolerant greens and one of the plant kingdom's richest source of omega-3 fatty acids is probably hiding in your garden right now. That would be purslane. I just found this purslane weed growing in the gardens at Baker Creek. So it grows wild pretty much all over the country. It has a lemony, tangy flavor, lightly succulent texture. It's very refreshing and crisp. It's excellent in salads, so I suggest you get out and forage this heat-tolerant green. As long as it's safe, you make sure that this is not an area that's been exposed to pesticides or any kind of chemicals that would be taken up by the plant. Now, if you want to take it to the next level and grow purslane yourself, there are domesticated varieties. These are not aggressive weedy varieties. They've got bigger leaves. They have an upright posture to them. Purslane, the weedy form of purslane, grows as a mat along the ground. But if you're growing the domesticated variety, it's going to grow upright. It's going to have bigger leaves, but it's still got that signature tangy citrusy flavor and that really nice succulent texture. It's a rich source of omega-3 fatty acids, definitely a superfood. It certainly qualifies, and it's super easy to grow. And it loves the hot weather. So definitely try this as one of your heat tolerant greens. Excellent cooked. It's a popular pot herb cooked and boiled down in Europe. It's also a great raw eating salad green. It adds a really nice texture to salads and stir fries. So give it a try. Totally versatile, super heat loving. It's a great plant. So I had no idea that you could even eat the greens and foliage of the sweet potato plant, but indeed you can. In fact, it's actually a great sweet potato flavor in these leaves, and it's a super heat tolerant cooking green. This is one that you're going to eat cooked. It's going to impart that classic sweet potato flavor. They're super dark green, which is indicative of lots of nutrition. They've got that beautiful sweet potato flavor, a really great cooking green, and they thrive in summer heat. They're never going to be bashful even during a super heat stroke. They're super easy to grow. And bonus, you're gonna get big, beautiful sweet potato tubers at the end of the season. So maybe you're looking for something that's gonna provide both heat tolerance and cool weather tolerance. That would be Swiss chard. Swiss chard handles extreme heat and extreme cold. It's a really super well-adapted plant. It's related to beets and spinach distantly. It's got this really nice minerally flavor, very similar to spinach, super tender, glossy leaves. You can get a variety called five color silver beet that's gonna have, it's more like a rainbow chard, but perpetual spinach Swiss chard is one of the more heat tolerant varieties. So I love this variety for getting spinach-like greens throughout that hot summer weather, and also incredibly nutritious. So Calaloo amaranth is a green that you can get in throughout the season. It's really never too late to plant this green. Even in the hottest part of the summer, you can get it to germinate and harvest it very quickly because it's a quick growing green and it's gonna make these beautiful tender leaves. Amaranths tend to do really well in hot weather, and Calaloo was bred not to go to seed too quickly. Calaloo is actually, it's an amaranth, and it's related to things like celosias and coxcomb. So this is more of an ornamental celosia coxcomb, but this is related to Calaloo. So you're gonna get these nice tender leaves with Calaloo. It's something that's typically cooked. You can eat it raw, especially the younger leaves, but Calaloo is very best when it's cooked and added with spices. It's a Caribbean green. Roselle is one of the most multi-purpose plants that I know of. I love this plant. It's super sour. The leaves, so this is super heat tolerant. The leaves have this amazing kind of tart, sour flavor. It's a great cooking green. You can shred it finely and put it in salads. It's great to eat raw. This is going to impart a tangy flavor in your dishes, so be aware of that. It's got kind of a lemony citrus quality. It's a really great flavor. It is good for you. This plant is also an edible ornamental. It's gonna put out beautiful blooms throughout the summer. It's actually a hibiscus relative. So you're getting beautiful leafy greens, heat tolerant leafy green substitute. You're getting fleshy calyxes that can be made into kind of a hibiscus tea. And then it's going to finally put out flowers. And throughout the season, no matter how hot it gets, it's always gonna put off these beautiful, immature leaves that are super tender and great for eating raw or cooked in salads. So definitely give Roselle a try. And if you must grow lettuce in the summer, I know lettuce is very challenging to grow in the heat of summer, but some people are ambitious or stubborn gardeners and they need to have that lettuce in the heat of summer. Try either Yedikule or crisp mint. These are gonna be the most heat tolerant. I'm not making any promises. If you're in extreme heat, it's the middle of summer, lettuce is going to suffer. There are a few tips and tricks that you can implement to have a better lettuce crop in the heat of summer. Things like using shade cloth, keeping your plants really well watered, surrounding your established plants with a few layers of mulch. So adequate moisture, shade cloth, or just identifying a shady microclimate in your garden, maybe below something tall and shady like a shade casting, like a sunflower. Planting it at the base of a shade casting plant, keeping things moist, and adding plenty of mulch. Those are going to help to have a better lettuce crop. But again, no promises. It's not the easiest crop for the heat of summer. So try crisp mint or Yedikule. Orach is actually related to spinach. It's got these bright, vibrant colored leaves, and it's more resistant to bolting. When orach does finally go to bolt, it actually makes really beautiful seed heads that can be used for floral arranging. This is a top choice for edible landscaping. It's gonna add this beautiful pop of purple or red to the landscape, and it's a super heat tolerant green with delicious spinach flavor. The most tender and tasty spinach substitutes that we've found is Chinese red leaf amaranth. So it's a true amaranth. It's in the amaranth family. It's related to coxcomb and celosia. This variety is from China. It's super tender. It's even just feeling the leaves right now, this feels like satiny soft. We have a few bug damage here because we're practicing organic farming, but it doesn't matter. This is so soft and silky texture. a really nice, mild, kind of nutty flavor. And it is the heat of summer. It's the end of July here in Mansfield, Missouri. It gets super hot here. We've had days this past week, we had a major heat wave. So we're looking at beautiful greens that are withstanding some serious heat, and they're still putting out tender, tasty, mild. There's no bitter flavor to this. So if you're looking for that spinach substitute that's going to give you that lightly mineral flavor like spinach does, nice and mild, great for cooking, great for raw, for salads, mix it with things like pecans and cranberries, this would be your top choice. And it's so incredibly tender. And as you can see, it's also a beautiful edible ornamental. This splash of color is fantastic. Now, we have significant pest pressure at this time, but throughout the season, you're getting beautiful leaves splashed with purple color, splashed with red color, extra tender, the ideal spinach substitute for high summer. And you can start this one super late in the season. If it's July right now and you're wondering what greens you can still get in, try some Chinese red leaf amaranth. That's actually perfect right now. It's a quick grower. You can harvest it for baby greens. You can germinate it in the super hot. So an easy grower, super tender, perfect spinach substitute. So those are our favorite heat tolerant greens. This is gonna provide you with the most delicious and nutritious leafy greens all summer long.